Hello children, welcome to the another class of English. Today, in this session, we are going to deal with Unit 6 of Class 8 and it is titled Art and Culture. In this, we are going to deal with Sea Reading. Maestro with a Mission. Children, can you identify who is he? Yes. He is the most prominent person in the first half of the 20th century. Who played a great role in bringing Kuchipudi to the limelight of the people? Yes. Children, he also brought lot of fame to our Telugu states. He is none other than Vempati Chinnasatyam, who later came to be known as Dr. Vempati Chinnasatyam. Children, initially this dance form Kuchipudi was performed by all male troupe. Later, as the days passed, female were also allowed to perform. Before we start our further reading of the text, let's see some glossary. Feather in a cap. It's an idiom, children. The meaning of it is achievement. Stupendous, amazingly large. And the next one is maestro, a great performer. You have already come across this word in our session 1, children. Reverent, filled with honor. Illustrious, remarkable. The next one is emergence. The meaning of emergence is evolution. Full-fledged, complete. Bring laurels. The meaning of bring laurels is make famous. Nostalgic, unforgettable. And we can also write the other meaning as having a feeling of sadness mixed with pleasure. Tinsel world, film world. Here this word refers to, here in this lesson, this word refers to Telugu film industry. Let's try to recollect what we have understood in our session 1 so far. Okay. So, children, yes, this is a story of Dr. Vempati Chinnasatyam, who dedicated his life for the cause of Kuchipudi. Yes, he was born in a poor family in Kuchipudi village. From his childhood, he has a strong desire to take the Kuchipudi dance form to the status of a classical dance. Yes, and children, we have also learned that this is a dance form originated in the village Kuchipudi. In the beginning, this dance form was only limited to the temple phase. Men used to perform the role of women also. Yes, and some great gurus reformed it and transformed it. Still, it was not recognized as a classical form of dance. In the last session, we have also studied that Vempati has left his house at the age of 18. Yeah, he walked all the way to Chennai from his village. How many kilometers he has walked, children? Yes, he has walked nearly 400 kilometers. In Chennai, he tried his luck in the film world, children. He had a few successes to his credit. Yeah, we have studied, we have completed till here, children. Now, let's continue with our further reading. Tadepalli Peraya Shastri and Vedantam Lakshmi Narayana Shastri taught him the difficult aspects of Kuchipudi style and inspired him. Yeah. Satyam developed a genuine and ardent interest towards the art form. he was really interested in this Kuchipudi art form children. He sometimes sold his meal tickets to watch the dance programs in Chennai. Sometimes what he used to do is, whatever the meal tickets he got, he used to sell those meal tickets in order to watch the dance programs in Chennai. He only wanted to liberate Kuchipudi from the clutches of insignificance and oblivion. With the encouragement from his cousin Vempati Peddasathyam, the name of his cousin is Vempati Peddasathyam. Vempati Chinnasathyam tried his luck in Telugu film world. Can the Telugu film lovers forget the dance sequences in Nartanasala, Devadasu and Pandava Vanavasam? Yeah. We are now continuing with the third line, children. Yes. Nartanasala, Devadasu and Pandava Vanavasam. Even now, the film admirers become nostalgic when they recollect these sequences. Yeah, those sequences, the dance sequences which he has performed, he has choreographed in this movies are really, they become nostalgic, children. Thus, Dr. Vempati has carved a night in Telugu films as well as a dance director. Dr. Vempati was not satisfied with his success in the tinsel world. In this world, he was not satisfied with his success. His desire to popularize Kuchipudi grew stronger. He even wanted to popularize Kuchipudi more, this dance form more. He established Kuchipudi Art Academy for this purpose. So, as he wanted to popularize this dance form, he established an academy, Kuchipudi Art Academy, in 1963 in Madras. As many as 180 solo items and 15 dance dramas were composed and choreographed by Dr. Vempati. Yeah, 180 solo items and 15 dance forms were composed by him, children. Those have been performed all over the world. He composed his first dance drama, Sri Krishna Parijatam, followed by Shira Sagara Madanam. Both were received well by the audience all around the world and brought laurels to Vempati. You know, these two dance forms brought so much of name to Vempati. Some of the masterpieces like Padmavati Srinivasa Kalyanam, composed by Dr. Vempati, are the symbols of depth of his knowledge and mastery over Kuchipudi. All these masterpieces shows the depth of his knowledge and mastery over Kuchipudi. He had an ability to communicate each nuance of the dance to connoisseurs and laypersons equally well. Dr. Vempati's distinguished disciples include Shanta Rao, Yamini Krishnamurthy, Vaijayanti Mala Bali, Hema Malini, Manju Bhargavi, Shobha Naidu, Balakondal Rao, and Daggubati Purandeshwari, etc. See, all these famous people are disciples of Vempati. Even one of these disciples takes pride in being a disciple of, every one of these disciples takes pride in being a disciple of Dr. Vempati. For all that he has done to the development and emergence of Kuchipudi to a full-fledged dance form, Dr. Vempati was rightly conferred the much coveted Padma Bhushan title by the Government of India. Yeah, the Government of India has awarded him the Padma Bhushan title. Andhra University awarded him the honorary doctorate in 1980. He was awarded Andhra University doctorate in the year 1980. Sri Venkateshwara University, Tirupati. This Venkateshwara University is in Tirupati, children. It honored him with an honorary degree, the literature, in 1983. Dr. Satyam was presented with the Golden Key by the mayor of Miami, USA Stephen P. Clark, in the year 1981. He was chosen for the Sangeet Natak Academy Fellowship, and the Raja Lakshmi Foundation Madras presented the Raja Lakshmi Award. He was awarded the Raja Lakshmi Award also, children. These are only a few to mention. These are only a few in his cap. There are a lot more. Speaking about his achievements, there are a lot more to speak. There are so many feathers in his cap. In the year 1976, the TTD made Satyam the Astana Natyacharya. Yes. So, in the year the TTD it's Tirumala Tirupati Devasthanam children. It gave Asthana Natyacharya to Vempati Chinnasathyam. Knowing about the further details of his birth and his family, these are like this. He was born to Venkata Chalamayya and Varalakshmi on 15th October 1929. He was born in the year 1929. He led an illustrious life of 83 years and breathed his last on 29 July 2012. He was survived by his wife Swarajya Lakshmi, two sons and three daughters. All the Telugu speakers identify themselves with Kuchipudi. Yeah, because of him, the Kuchipudi has got a prominent role in both the states of both the Telugu states. Yeah, the rest of the world looks at Kuchipudi and Dr. Vempati's stupendous work with the reverent eyes. Kuchipudi has established itself on par with other classical dance forms in India like Bharatanatyam, Kathak, and Kathakali. Yeah, along with all these three dances, Kuchipudi has also established a prominent role. Countless people worked for Kuchipudi, but Dr. Vempati remains the source of inspiration to such people. Even though so many people worked and still they are working for this beautiful dance form, he becomes as an inspiration. He remains as a source of inspiration for the dance form like Kuchipudi children. Yes. And he remains at the center stage of Kuchipudi's surge as a classical dance form in modern India. Hence, he can rightly be called Maestro with a Mission. Yes, by hearing all this, even we will agree that he is rightly be called as Maestro with a Mission. See the beauty that was involved in this dance form, children. Let's quickly check your understanding levels. Let's do our reading comprehension part, children. Yeah. Who thought difficult aspects of Kuchipudi and inspired Vempati? Yes. Thadepalli Peraya Shastri and Vedantam Lakshmi Narayana Shastri taught him the difficult aspects of Kuchipudi and inspired him. Let's see the next one. Vempati Chinnasathyam left his house on a purpose. Yeah, he left his house on a purpose. Do you think he was successful at the end? Even though he left his house on a purpose, do you all think that he was successful at the end? Yes, yes, he was successful. So let's start writing like this. Vempati Chinnasathyam left his house on a purpose. It was to elevate the status of Kuchipudi. Because of his efforts, Kuchipudi rose to the status of a classical dance. It was recognized nationally and internationally. Yes, because of its genuine efforts, this dance form was recognized nationally and internationally. His efforts were recognized everywhere. I think he was successful at the end. Is it appropriate to call him Dr. Vempati? Do you agree? Why not? Why or why not? Yes, it is appropriate to call him Dr. Vempati. He was an ardent lover of Kuchipudi. He knew everything about it. He was honored with the honorary doctorates by two universities. He was responsible for the astounding progress of Kuchipudi. So, it is fully justified to call him Dr. Vempati. Let's have a look at some antonyms, children. Dr. Vempati was not satisfied with the success in the tinsel world. The antonym of the word tinsel is undecorated. Yeah. Let's see the next one. Even now, the film admirers become nostalgic. The antonym of the word nostalgic is undesiring. Let's see the third one. His desire to popularize Kuchipudi grew stronger. द एंटोनिम ऑफ द वर्ड पॉपुलराइज इज डिस्क्रेडिट और शन. He was humiliated by the teacher in his village. The antonym of the word humiliated is glorious. Thank you, children. Hope you all followed the session.